Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com. Today is Tuesday, the 3rd of September, 2024. We're back from a long holiday weekend here in the U.S., and here are the key things you need to know ahead of today's U.S. session. Broadly speaking, in the Forex market, the U.S. dollar is extending last week's gains. The only exception to that move is the Japanese yen, helped along by some hawkish comments from Bank of Japan Governor Ueda. But again, we're seeing more of that trend that we saw last week with the U.S. dollar strengthening. Now, the question will be whether that can carry over throughout today's session and throughout the rest of the week as we start to enter some of the major economic data for this week, starting at 10 a.m. Eastern time with the ISM manufacturing PMI survey. If you think back to last month, this is the report that caused, that sparked at least a little bit of a panic in markets that led to a quick swoon in all risk assets and big moves in the Forex market as well. The good news is this survey is expected to improve this month to 47.5 from 46 or so last month. The key thing to watch, though, will be the employment subcomponent. That fell to a four-year low around 43 last month. We're hoping to see that bump up to reassure the Federal Reserve that the broader employment picture is improving and not deteriorating to the extent that it would require larger interest rate cuts across the rest of this year or into early next year. So that'll be the key report to watch for today. And then as we look ahead to today's chart of the day, it's the Australian dollar versus the US dollar. I've zoomed this out almost an entire year just so we can see the recent moves in more context. We've seen a very quickly off of those lows from the last PMI report that led to swoon down to 63.50. We've traded as high as almost 68.50 last week, but it appears that the market is struggling to hold above that 68 level. I wouldn't be surprised to see at least a near-term pullback, especially if that ISM manufacturing survey comes in a bit better than expected. Key level to watch if we do fall further from here is around 67. So we're just bouncing between those key round handles, at least on this daily chart. 67 and 68 are the key levels to watch for the Aussie this week. That is today's video. Thank you for carving a couple minutes out of your day to watch. And regardless of whether you're catching us on Twitter or YouTube, please do like this video. Give me a follow on Twitter and subscribe to our channel on YouTube. That helps us with the algorithms and is a great free way to show your support and keep us doing more of these videos moving forward. Thanks and best of luck with your trading this week.